Hello friends, welcome to the video series on interview question for SQL PLSQL developers. This video is a continuation of the previous video where I have explained about what is the compound trigger and what are all the various timing event within compound trigger and what are all the advantages of compound trigger. In fact, in the last slide of previous video, I just mentioned few advantages of compound trigger. In the entire video, I would have talked about how the compound trigger consolidates all the individual timing events of individual trigger. So this was the main point what I have explained in the previous video. Only in the last slide, I just showed you the advantages of compound trigger. However, I didn't show you any examples for compound trigger. So I just want to show you an example to understand the advantages of compound trigger in this video. So in this video, I'm just going to focus on two points. One is like how compound trigger helps in sharing the variables across various timing events and how compound trigger helps effectively load data from one table to another using bulk collector. Probably about how to avoid mutating table error using compound trigger. This part I will cover while posting the mutating trigger related videos. If you have not watched the previous video about compound trigger, I would strongly suggest you to watch the previous video and then continue watching this video. In this video, we are going to understand two advantages of compound trigger. One is like how to effectively use the variables across various timing events in compound trigger and how compound trigger helps in loading the data effectively using bulk collect. Fine. Now let us see the problem statement. So we have a table like employee and the expectation is whenever I am updating the salary of an employee, I want the log to be captured in a table called T underscore change log. So we want to capture the employee number, the date on which salary is modified and the description of change. So we basically want to capture what was the old salary and what was the new salary. For example, suppose if you are updating the salary of employee 7788, so his actual salary is 3101. And his new salary is going to be 100. So the expectation is whenever we are doing an update statement, the T underscore change log table should be populated with the entry like this. So here, if you see, we should capture the old salary and we should capture the new salary and the date on which the salary was modified. So this is the expectation. So this is very simple because one of the main advantage of trigger is for logging. So we can use the simple DML trigger to achieve this functionality. Fine. Now let's see how to use the trigger. So we can use the after update trigger. So here I'm using an after update trigger of salary. So whenever the salary column is being updated for each row, that means this is a row level trigger. For every row that is getting affected, this trigger will get fired and this trigger is going to populate the T change log table. So basically what it will do, it will take the old salary from here 3101 and it will take the new salary from the statement. So both are going to get populated into the T change log table. So this is a very simple solution for this problem. So we can create a row level after update trigger which will populate the log table whenever we are doing an update operation. Very simple. Now let me show you the demo, then we'll see what is the problem with this approach. Okay, so here is the employee table. I'm creating the T change log table. The table is created. Now I'm creating the after update row level trigger. The trigger is created. Now let me update the employee table. And I'm updating the salary of an employee 7788 with salary equal to 100. So it's one row updated. Now let us check what is the row that is populated in T change log. So you can see here the old salary was 3101 and the new salary is 100. Fine. Okay. So this solution is perfectly fine. But the problem with the solution is, suppose if you want to update all the employee salary, for example, I want to give an increment of 10% for all the employees. So typically we will update the salary of all the employees incrementing by 10%. So our update statement will be like update employee set salary equal to salary plus 10% of the salary. So this is going to be our new salary. So what will happen? This update statement will go and update all the employees. In case if there are, let us assume that in case if there are like 1 lakh employees in the table, then what will happen? This update statement will fire the after update trigger for every change in a row. If 1 lakh table is 1 lakh rows are going to get updated, then this trigger will get fired and 1 lakh insert statements will get fired. I just want to reiterate this point again. When this update statement is fired, it's going to affect 1 lakh record, and for every row getting affected, the trigger will get automatically fired and the trigger will invoke the insert statement. So a single update statement is invoking 1 lakh insert statements. So this is potentially a performance issue. That means when you are doing an update, it in turn triggers 1 lakh insert statements. So this will have a huge impact on the performance. So this is the issue with the design. Fine. Now let us see how can we avoid this problem. So let us try to improve the solution now. Okay. So now instead of writing a trigger, like instead of writing an after update trigger, we are going to follow a slightly modified approach now. Okay. Let me show you what I'm going to do here. When we are updating, I'm going to create a package called package one, and I'm just going to create a nested table variable. Okay, like LV log changes. I'm creating a variable. So I'm now creating a after update row level trigger, same trigger, but now in this time, I'm not inserting from this trigger. Instead, I'm capturing all the information to be inserted. You can see here. One is like what is the employee ID getting for what employee ID we are updating the salary, the date on which the update is happening, and the log, like what was the old salary and what was the new salary. Now all these information we are populating into the collection variable what we defined in the package. So in this place, using this trigger, we are not inserting. Instead, we are just collecting the information to be inserted. That means for every row, the informations are collected and stored in the packaged variable. You can see here we are extending here and we are keep storing this information. So for every row, the informations are loaded into this collection. Once the entire informations are loaded, using after update statement level trigger, because the statement level trigger is going to get fired only once for a statement. It is not like a row level trigger. The row level trigger will get fired for each and every row getting affected, whereas the statement level trigger will get fired just once. And here we are using after update statement level trigger. So once the update operation is completed, by that time the variable would have been populated with all the necessary information to be loaded. So finally, we are just inserting into the table using for all bulk collect statement. So this is the most effective way. When we compare this solution with our previous solution, in the previous solution, the insert statement is getting fired for each and every row that is getting changed. Whereas in this solution, the informations are collected into a collection variable, and from the collection variable, we are inserting into the table just only once using the bulk collect. So this will significantly improve the performance, and from a performance point of view, this is very good design compared to our previous approach. Now let me execute and show you this code, then we'll see where we are going to use this compound trigger. Okay, so here I am creating the package which is going to hold the collection variable, and here I am creating the after update row level trigger which is going to populate the collection variable. So the trigger is created. So here I am creating the statement level trigger, that is after update statement level trigger. The trigger is created. Now I am updating the employees of department 20 with increment in salary by 100. This has updated 4 records. Let us check the log table. Now you can see For 4 employees, the old salary and the new salary informations are captured. So in this case, it's not like a 4 insert statement. Instead, it is just one insert statement using the bulk collect, which happens at the after update trigger. Fine, let me roll back here. And I'm just dropping all these triggers and packages because the next I'm going to create the compound trigger here. Fine. Now let us see why we are going to create a compound trigger. So the solution is perfectly fine, but the problem with the solution is to achieve this simple solution, we are creating 3 objects: a package to hold the collection variable and a row level trigger and a statement level trigger. So the row level trigger is basically to populate the collection variable, and statement level trigger is basically to insert into the log table. So basically we are using 3 different objects, a package and 2 triggers. Instead of using 3 different objects, the entire functionality can be implemented using single compound trigger. So here is the equivalent compound trigger. You can see this is a compound trigger. Okay, this is a compound trigger. This, whatever the variables we declared here, now we are declaring in the global section of the compound trigger, so that this variable can be used across the timing event, which was not possible in the earlier case. But using compound trigger, the global variable can be shared across the timing event. So this is the reason I told you to watch the previous video to understand what is a compound trigger. Fine. The second advantage is, of course, here also we can use the bulk collect, and that is another advantage. But the primary thing I just want you to concentrate here is that the variables can be shared across the timing event. Okay, so these are the 2 advantages. One is like the global variables can be shared across various timing events within compound trigger, and this helps in effectively load the changes from one table to another using bulk collect. Now I will show you the compound trigger demo. Okay, so here is the compound trigger. Instead of writing a package and 2 different triggers, now I'm just creating one single compound trigger. Now let us update for the employees who are working in department 20. Now let's select the information. Now all the informations are selected. So this is one of the main advantages of compound trigger, and a compound trigger helps in solving the mutation problem also. Probably in some other video I will cover what is a mutation, how to resolve mutation without using compound trigger and with using compound trigger, and what is the difference between them. Those things probably will cover in the next set of videos. If you have learned something new, please like this video, subscribe, and stay tuned for new feature video, interview question, SQL practical question, and concept videos. If you want any questions to be answered, you can post it in the comment section, or you can drop to this mail ID. And thanks a lot for watching this video.